Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the afternoon takes place in the Ur Featherweight Division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Team Rhino Waterford, Kevin Teo! And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing SPG Clonmel, Sean
Okay, so we're back up to 3 minute rounds now, Andrew. Three minute rounds. Kevin Kyo straight in on the striking, in on a double leg, single leg, switch back to the double, and drag Sean McCullough to the floor, wasting no time, working to pass the guard. He's not holding back here.
No, there's always a moment of maybe worry or anticipation when you see the head on the outside of a takedown like that. And there's always the chance of the quick re-guard, you know, and the guillotine can become a threat, but seems to be negating it very strongly here. Looking for...
passed a complete mount here. He's passing into the side control. Really aggressive start from Kevin Kyo, who's making his amateur debut right now, but not showing any signs of tentativeness.
Funny enough, as his opponent was walking out, as Sean was walking out, Kevin's coach has said to him, calm down here now, calm down, get your breath. Maybe anticipating that he was going to come out the gates like this.
Yeah. We'll see, can he keep up this pace, because it's a fairly frenetic pace to begin with. Again, gets McCullough to the floor. McCullough working hard to get a foothold in this fight. He's now mounted. McCullough is 0-1, lost the decision in December on Clan Wars. This is his second outing. against this head and arm. This head and arm looks threatening.
Yeah, this is what he was trying to set up earlier on from the side control, and he tried to pass into the mount with it. You see, it's unlucky for him because he's at the side of the cage where he'd like to go off to try and sprawl out to finish it. This is a serious amount of energy being used by Kevin in the mount.
He's gotten to that side now. He created room for himself beautifully. That looks tight. That looks tight. He is expending a lot of energy trying to get this finish, isn't he? There's a lot of brute force.
And the position that he has his chest on is interesting. No, I think he is safe here. There's just a lot of pressure that's happening here. Not necessarily a choke because he's very high up on the situation.
Yeah, he needs to have his head over on the nice outside frame of that arm. And he just didn't have the pressure in a technical sense. It was all physical, wasn't it?
Yeah, it seemed like a lot of the pressure was coming down through the center of his head as opposed to choking him under the neck with the head and arm choke.
All the important parts weren't in the right places, and now McCullough gets back to his feet. How much energy has Kyo used up in those exchanges? We can see where McCullough wants this fight. He wants it in the standing exchanges. He looks very confident with his hands and his kicks. That's a nice left hook.
Now, it might be looking into it a wee bit too much, but Kevin seems to be fighting with his mouth open already.
Yeah. He did go fairly hard in the paint there for the first 90 seconds of this bout. McCullough using the underhook well just to keep his opponent trapped. Digging in with some body shots. Great first round.
Yeah, Kevin seems to have grown more confident in the feet there as the round went on. You could do it a bit of tape on Sean's glove, it looks like. Aaron Wallace, of course. More eagle-eyed than myself. He's already spotted it. The tape is on the glove, Paul.
Yeah. We only have the best of the best refing up for us today here. There's nothing getting by these guys. See such a fast-paced start to round two, or have the guys settled into their rhythm a little bit? Both guys, of course, wear black trunks, but Sean McCullough's the one with the tattoo on his belly.
I was trying to figure out what it said there, to be honest, Paul, when he was looking at us, but it's cursive, so I'm not able to read it.
Yeah, need to get a closer view. Kyo looks a little more relaxed now, bouncing around and not being so anxious and aggressive at the start of the round. Take your time, taking his time, getting his timing. Now he's in on a single leg again. Well, maybe on a double.
Yeah, some big attempts in that exchange from both men there, just falling short of the target.
Passes the guard beautifully on the way down to alleviate the pressure from that guillotine attempt. Corner screams for patience this time in the top position.
Yeah, he seems really, really in on this head and arm position, but Sean has done very well to get to his knees. Now he's going to get his back up against the cage.
McCullough's just trying to climb his way back step by step to the feet. Does so beautifully, of course. There's no knees to the head in the amateur rule set. Kyo using good head position to trap his opponent. Looking for that outside trip and gets it beautifully. Excellent takedown. Nice cross face to trap his opponent on the mat. Playing more of a thinking man's wrestling game in this round than he was in the first. Less raw aggression.
Yeah, it's definitely slowed down about 50%.
And it's more effective.
Yeah, he's not losing the position, not creating scrambles. I have to say, Sean has a nice position here with his knee. He's trying to regain knee and elbow control on the same side to get back in, just to recover back to a guard or prevent it, but no. Brilliant mount.
Lovely pass from Kevin Keogh. And we were worried about his cardio, maybe, or having an adrenaline dump after that extreme start to the first round, but he looks like he's enjoying his positioning out here. He's not looking like he's struggling at all.
Yeah, and trying to think a little bit more intelligent as well by purposely bringing his opponent over towards his own corner here.
Yeah,
he's walking
almost
him up in the mount.
Has that fullback mount, and the one hook, the two hooks in, attacking the neck now of McCullough.
Yeah, he swapped to the other side now. This could be it.
Just like in that first bout, we got a big stretch. Belly down, driving the hips in. McCullough fighting gamely, and he's escaped it beautifully.
Brilliant escape from Sean McCullough. It was a really nice setup with Kevin, from Kevin, because he was going for it one way. Sean started defending it. He just slipped the hand in, going the opposite direction. That was a serious show of heart from Sean McCullough here. Very good.
Into a third round now. You'd have to imagine Kevin Keogh is most likely two rounds to the good. McCullough's going to need something decisive to turn the fight back in his favour.
He likes that right head kick. He's thrown that two or three times in the fight already.
Yeah, looks confident in it, although he might want to start setting it up with some strikes or feints. Beautiful shot from McCullough. Now he's lost the position in the scramble.
Lovely instant reaction from Kevin when he hit the ground there. Not necessarily a butterfly sweep, but same sort of motion. He's looking for a Darce here.
And it's tight, Andrew. If he hooks the leg, which he does, this is going to be a problem. Kind of fighting gamely again. He just doesn't give in easily in these positions.
Embarrassing to say it as a brown belt. That actually may have been an anaconda. I'm not 100% sure on that,
yeah,
because I never get the two of them.
I'm the same, man. Yeah. All those years of training, but one goes under the armpit, one goes around the choking arms around the neck. So they look almost identical.
After a flyer,
yeah,
here today. Brilliant stuff.
Two brown belts getting the jiu-jitsu submission attempts mixed up.
That's a really high guillotine.
And we can see Kyo's face. He's really struggling with that squeeze, but he looks okay now.
Wow.
Very aggressive grappling from both guys.
Yeah, we've seen that two or three times already from Sean this afternoon, and I do feel for him because he's definitely felt a bite on several of those attempts. Kevin's just been really smart in using it to get to the side control straight away off the submission.
He's reacted well each time, just like that last reversal he got. He's not accepting bottom positions. He's not accepting these submission attempts. Instead of freezing up and trying to defend, he's scrambling while there's still a small chance of getting some movement. He's in a top position here as we're running down towards the end of the bout. His grappling's looked excellent, I have to say, in this. He's impressed me for a guy who's making his amateur debut.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I would say that when we're looking back at this fight, or when both men are looking back at it, Sean will feel, my goodness,
beautiful up kick from Sean McCullough
to improve maybe some of the not necessarily the finishing mechanics of the submissions, but not jumping into a fully committed submission if he doesn't think it's fully there.
Yeah.
And then Kevin has to be really proud of his control, both against the cage, in a mount position, in the back, also in the side control.
Yeah, I mean, in the first minute or so, he started out like the blinkers were on and he was chasing that finish, but now he's settled into his rhythm and he's looked very good, made the right decisions at the right times. Great pressure here. Head position is great. So he's playing with the wrist and landing shots on the break. Lovely timing. Big strong right arm underhook. McCullough pulls guard, just diving on something.
He went for a flying triangle. Colin in his corner was saying, you have the rest, go for it. There's only 10 seconds left. Not a bad shout. Go for it. If it works, it works.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to your judges' scorecard for a decision. Your judges have scored this bout 30-27, 30-27, and 30-26 for your winner, Kevin!